Tonight we hear from one of the hundreds of Americans taken off a cruise ship in Japan, airlifted to a U.S. military base. Gay Corter spent 10 days stuck in quarantine on the Diamond Princess. Now, back on American soil, she tells us why the U.S. government's late-night rescue has made her more fearful than ever, in her own words.
We waited to leave the ship till middle of the night. It was deadly silent. It was like we're terrified. It was like we're getting into a cattle car. We didn't know. We were put on buses. We don't want to be breathing each other's air or anything. We're double masked up. The plane ride was like nothing on earth you can imagine. They wouldn't even tell us on the plane where we were going. This guy in a major hazmat suit was trying to divert a couple from sitting down by saying they had tested positive and they now had to be in this special chamber on the plane, which was like kind of plastic you'd see around a murder site or something. And she just had this look of shock and horror. I thought, wait a minute, she tested positive and she's on this plane? How could they have kept us 10, 14 days on the ship in complete isolation from one another? And then some bureaucrat made the decision to potentially infect us all on the plane for 12 hours in this close quarters. When we landed, we walked inside a big, brightly lighted room. It looked like it was all set up for a disaster drill with everybody again in hazmat suits. But as we walked in, the military were lined up and they were clapping for us. And if I burst into tears, it was like welcome home. Then they came around and said, you're not allowed out of your rooms for 2 weeks. We should be able to go outside. We need fresh air to stay healthy. It's just so hard for me to even talk about this.
That was Gay Corter in her own words.